For those of you who have been following my work, you know that I'm all about the community. What better way to get to know a community than to speak with the people that help feed them? I had the pleasure to visit one of the pop-up markets organized by the Food Bank of Central and Eastern North Carolina. I spoke with Cassie James, the pop-up markets coordinator.
What we're doing right now is part of the pop-up markets program with the Food Bank. So we're at Hopkins Chapel Baptist Church. We're here every first Thursday of the month. Right now we're from 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. for food distributions. And so what pop-up markets are is an additional direct distribution that's facilitated by the Food Bank. And most of the food that goes out is through our partner agencies, which are your food pantries, soup kitchens, local organizations like that.
In today's economy, the need for food and additional resources continue to rise.
We are seeing a growing need. The turnout for these has definitely grown since we started doing them last year. We serve on average about 250 households per distribution.
Everyone needs help sometimes, and engaging with the community helps bridge that gap between available resources and people who are in need. Cassie elaborates on community engagement and the importance of volunteers.
This kind of work really means a lot. It means a lot to engage with the people that we're serving. We do a client choice model, so folks, as you can see behind me, will grab a wagon and come through the line, and we let them pick out what their household can use. And we try to do a lot of fresh produce, and we have volunteers helping throughout. So most of the volunteers today are with the church, with Hopkins Chapel Baptist Church, and they are awesome. We have a lot of their youth here helping out. I mean, they've been just fantastic to work with and letting us come and use their space as well.
I also spoke with Gina Bryant, the youth director for Hopkins Chapel Baptist Church. Gina has seen the need for food dramatically increase.
We started with around 200 people. Last food bank, which was last month, we served over 800.
Not having enough food is a problem, but being located in rural areas can present additional challenges. Some people have no transportation, and resources in the country may be limited.
And there are not a lot of places available. People can't really drive into Raleigh and things like that. So our church just wanted to do something to help our community. We've noticed that there is a growing need for food, an essential that everybody needs. And we just wanted to be a part of that.
And for those wondering about the requirements to receive food,
there are really no requirements. You come in, you come here, you get in line. There are a few intake questions, like just so that the food bank can contact you if you need to. You don't have to be from a certain county. You don't have to be a certain income or anything. If you need food, you come get in this line and it's provided.
Gina pays homage to the food bank.
The Food Bank of Eastern North Carolina is an amazing organization, and I think they do a great service to our state.
Getting food to the community is a team effort. I spoke with J.D. Pittman, a truck driver for the food bank. J.D. elaborates on the concept of the pop-up markets.
The whole idea for the pop-up markets is to give people a chance to come and pick out what they need instead of just getting a pre-made box. It just gives us a chance to kind of engage with the community a little bit better and get to know people, see what their needs are, and better serve them.
J.D. reiterates the importance of community engagement.
Community engagement is one of the biggest things here. We do these all over the state, and I get people from different counties going to different pop-ups, and just being able to know them, get to know their family members, who they're picking up for and who they're helping out, is just another one of those things that gets us in touch with the community and help it so we can better serve them.
J.D. shares how the organization is proactive in trying to combat the problem of transportation that many families face.
We've seen that, you know, a lot of the prices are going up in supermarkets, and another problem is transportation, people not able to get out and get to where we're doing the distributions. So the thing that we do is we give people a chance to get what they need. We know it's getting a lot harder to get the things that they need out of the stores, so we're glad to bring it here to a location where they can easier get to. And we allow people to pick up for multiple families. So if we have people that are sick and shut in, we're able to get the food to them as well.
J.D. shares what he loves about his job.
The biggest thing for this job for me is I'm not sitting behind a desk all day. I gotta move, I gotta talk to people, I gotta engage, and this just gives me the perfect chance to do that. That's really why I love it. You get to see the impact that you're making firsthand, so that's the thing for me.
For more information on the pop-up markets, you can find them on Facebook. You can also visit Food Finder and enter your zip code to find additional resources near you. I really enjoy speaking with the people at the pop-up market. and I appreciate the time and effort that they all put into helping the community. It takes a village, and they are definitely touching lives, one food box at a time. For East Wake TV, I'm Monica Cooper, keeping you updated and informed.